I'm a Hindi translator. From last 12 years, I'm translating for many preachers, different preachers who are coming to Nagpur. When I was here, I got an opportunity to translate for Bishop Reed, and really it's a great privilege for me to translate for such a man of God. And his teaching is very, very simple. Even a simple person, even an illiterate person can apply it in his life and get the benefit from God. Mainly, I'm really impressed by his teaching that he concentrate only on, he just remove our attention from all the worldly things or some stuffs or some things, but he took all the attention and just diverted it to Jesus, the person. I'm really grateful for him that he came to Nagpur, and we are really impressed by his teaching. This is the first time in my life I became a believer. Since I became a believer from last 15 years, this is the first time I heard this type of teaching in my life, where he's not sharing anything about some getting some stuff or getting some blessing, getting some benefit from God, but he's saying just concentrate on Jesus, look unto Jesus. He's the author and finisher of our faith.
So many misunderstandings regarding Christianity. Years we are practicing that we have to pray so much and we have to fast and pray, then we get the anointing of God, blessing of God every time. But we were ignoring that Jesus lives in us. And really now we started reading Word of God. We are reading, but we were not thinking it. We now it's right that we have to change our thinking, that Jesus lives in us. And that is reality. It's not a thinking, it's reality. And we have to practice a reality.
So will you be fasting now?
No, we will feast now. Because Bishop Rick told to my husband, go and have a good breakfast. Don't fast.
Love each other, just as I have loved you, should you love each other.
कि एक दूसरे से प्रेम रखो जैसे मैंने तुमसे प्रेम रखा है वैसा ही तुम भी एक दूसरे से प्रेम रखो.
Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples.
यदि आप आपस में प्रेम रखोगे तो इसी से सब जानेंगे कि तुम मेरे चेले हो.
And that's when Peter ignored all this love stuff.
ये वो स्थान है जहां पर पतरस.
They went back to the same question.
वो वापस उसी एक प्रश्न के पीछे पड़ गए थे.
They ignored this talk that Jesus said about relationship. They kept going along the wrong path and asking him the wrong questions.
We are not satisfied. We want more. So this conference is not the end of our relationship with Bishop Michael Reed. This is just the beginning.
He who has seen me has seen the Father.
जिसने मुझे देखा उसने पिता को देखा है.
They still didn't get it. So Philip tries.
और वहाँ पर फिलिप था. फिलिप को अब तक वो बात नहीं समझी. और फिलिप अपने तरीके से कोशिश करता है.
You know, I love the disciples.
आप जानते हैं मैं चेलों से बहुत प्यार करता
हूँ. They so remind myself of me.
When I came to know about Dr. Ruth, when she last time she was here in India, and I was really blessed by her words. At that time I was thinking she is a blessed woman, and she speaks so intelligently and so this thing.
While hearing Ruth speaking, I sensed that this meeting is going to be a transforming experience to the Christian leaders in India.
I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. It's all to do with relationship. It's nothing to do with great big revelation.
हमें केवल ये पूछना होगा कि प्रभु कौन.
And the who is Jesus.
और वो कौन कोई और नहीं लेकिन यीशु स्वयं है.
Amen. There is no formula.
उसका कोई रीति नहीं है उसके लिए.
There is no great big secret.
उसका कोई बहुत बड़ा भेद नहीं है प्रियो.
This is the person of Jesus.
Wherever Bishop Reed preaches around the world, he tells people the same thing. That God has done everything, He's in control, and we don't have to struggle to earn our salvation. And all around the world, he sees God confirm the gospel message with miracles. And India was to be no different. God performed wonderful, life-changing miracles amongst the people.
He's from Nepal. This brother has come from Nepal.
Yes, brother, tell me.
Okay, he had a terrible knee frame problem. This frame of his knee was not working properly. He is a taekwondo and a boxing player.
Is it right?
Nice. He was a taekwondo and boxing player. And while he was doing his taekwondo and boxing, he fell down and he hurt his knee. The knee was very bad. I could not move and walk properly, sit properly. And I said to my wife, perhaps one day they will, my knee has to be, my leg has to be chopped off. Because of that, thought, I was worried and I never wanted to go to a doctor. He says, when Bishop called me here for prayer, I came and I was expecting, though I wanted to be healed. And so when Bishop said that, keep your hand on the area where you have disease, so when I kept my hand and when Bishop prayed, I felt the power of God going through my body. And now, today as I stand here, I am completely healed. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Now.
So now...
Just let it go. Couldn't do it. It's gone. Just simple, wasn't it?
Okay, this is a gentleman who's had chronic backache, pain in the lower part of his back. It was so severe that he couldn't sit still. He constantly had to adjust his position. Bishop Austin lays hands on the part that hurt, and he prayed for him. And since then, he's been completely healed. We've put him through his paces. We've asked him to get down, bend down, complete up and down, which he couldn't do. Can you bend forward all the way?
4 or 5 years I was having this severe spondylitis problem and I was unable to sit for much longer time. Like since yesterday, I sat without the belt, without the collar. Yes, and I used to cry and pray here also. I cried and prayed. And I was hesitating to come in front.
Today?
Yeah, today also. Then I said, no, this is the time where I have to go and give my testimony for the Lord. I will go, and with that faith I came forward, and that is how I got that touch in me. That spirit really touched me, and that pain which I was having, only one pain used to pain a lot, like this right hand side. Yeah, now I'm able to free.
Before this, could you move your
neck? No. I was finding it difficult to stretch like
back.
This.
Can you come forward now? Touch your chin to your chest and back up again. Can you come back here? Look to the left and to the right. And that's not painful at all. They look sideways and again. And there's no pain in the shoulder at all. And you can bend forward.
Yeah, I can bend. See, I can bend up with up.
Well done.
He says that for past year, he had some nerve problem. And because of that, he had lost sensation in his left knee and the area around that knee. He could not feel. And sometimes he used to get the twitching pain. But now, today, he's completely healed. He's saying that this particular portion was senseless. It became numb. There was no senses. Like, you know, he could not feel any pain. But today, now he can feel. For past 2 years, she had pain in her chest. Yeah, when Bishop said that lay your hand on that area, I laid my hand and I prayed and Jesus touched me. Now I don't have any pain. She says there's no pain. Now freely she can breathe.
तो मेरा एक्सीडेंट हुआ था और यहाँ पे बहुत दर्द यानी पेन हो रहा था 12 साल से तो आज अभी परमेश्वर ने मुझे छुआ और एकदम चंगाई मिली.
12 years back I met with an accident and I was having knee pain, but now I'm totally and completely healed.
Thank you, Jesus.
At the end of the pastors' conference, Bishop and Mrs. Reed presented all the pastors and leaders with a gift of Bishop Reed's book, It's So Easy, which had been translated into Hindi.
This is the book that has been translated in Hindi, and it is called It's So Easy. Hallelujah.